Hi, thanks for watching the video. I'm Todd Baginski. I'm a Microsoft MVP and the partner and CTO at Canvas. In this video, I'm going to give you an end-to-end demonstration of the Meeting Capture Power App sample template. When the Power App initially loads, it presents you a list of your upcoming meetings. You can scroll through these meetings to find the ones that make sense for you to take notes on, and then select on them and do so. For example, here I can select this one, which at the time I'm recording this video is about 35 minutes from now, and then you can hit Start Meeting. Before I go further in this meeting and in this actual presentation, I'm going to adjust my calendar invite so that this meeting is occurring right now to show you some additional functionality you get when that's the case. Okay, so I just updated my meeting invite in my Outlook calendar, and now I'm going to refresh the Power App here so it loads up and you can see what the behavior looks like when you actually have a meeting going on right when you open the Power App. So again, it's 3:30 p.m. my time now, and I'm opening up this Power App, and as you can see, the time that it is where I'm at right now is soundly in the middle of when this meeting occurs. So it pre-selects it for me, and then I just click the Start Meeting button to get going. So when I click the Start Meeting button here, whether I chose the meeting or the app chose it for me, the experience is exactly the same. First, I get this pop-up dialog, and it tells me, hey, once you've captured your meeting, remember to finish and click Finish and Save. Otherwise, you'll lose all your notes, the tasks, and any attachments you've saved in this Power App. So I say, okay, got it. I'll remember that. And now you can see this is what the Power App looks like when it first starts. So we've pulled a lot of information here about the meeting right into the Power App. You can see the title of the meeting at the top called Power Apps Deep Dive Videos. You can see the date and the time at which it starts and ends, as well as its duration. You'll probably also notice the countdown timer at the top. That's telling you how much time is left in this meeting according to what you scheduled it for. And you may have already noticed that the little bar below it is actually moving to the right very slowly. So this is a visual indicator that shows you how much time you have left in your meeting. Now in the top left portion of the app here, we have the attendees. This pulls in all the attendees who were part of your meeting in Outlook, and it gives you the option to email them separately by clicking this email button like that. And I can put in a subject and message and send them a message through Outlook right within the Power App. Don't even need to open up Outlook. I can also email every one of the attendees if I click this email button at the top. Or if I choose to take some people off of the to list, I can just quickly hit the X button and pull them off. And again, put in a subject, a message, and send it to them. So that's a real nice way to quickly send a message to ask somebody to follow up, or maybe even just say, hey, the meeting started, where are you at? In addition to the attendee functionality, we also display the meeting details. These details are actually coming out of the body that you would see for a calendar invite in Outlook. Full HTML is supported here, so it will render it to look exactly like you saw in your meeting invite. And the links here work too. Notice when I mouse over the hyperlinks to join this Skype meeting, my cursor turns into a hand. And if I click them, it will open up the web browser and join me right to the meeting. I'm also able to take notes here in the notes section, just like that. This is just a regular text. Full HTML or rich text editing is not supported as a control yet in Power App, but you do have the capability to take text notes there. You can also add tasks for people to do something directly to Planner. So if I want to add a task, I can either click the plus button and open the form and it'll have blank in the top, or I can put in the task right here like this, and then when I'm ready to assign it, click the plus button and the text is pre-populated. I can choose which date I'd like that to be done with a nice date picker, and then I can assign it to anybody in the meeting. Or I could also go and look for somebody who's not in the meeting to assign it to by just simply entering their name here and seeing all the people in my directory who have that name. I'll just assign this one to myself for right now, and then save the task. I have the option here to assign another task if I'd like, but since we're just doing a quick video, I'll just close. You can also take pictures and draw sketches inside of the Power App as well. So first, I'll open the sketchboard by clicking the icon on the left. Then I can select my pen and I can draw myself a nice picture. I can change colors here, whatever I'd like to do. The full capability of the sketch control is available here. And when you're done with it, you just hit save sketch and now you can draw another one. For example, now I have two circles on the page. The next thing you can do is you can take pictures. So if you click the picture icon here, you can see me in the video right there with my webcam, and I'll click the button to take a picture. Now I just click the check mark and my picture is saved. When I go back to the top of the Power App here, I can now see all these different things that I saved by clicking on this attachment icon up at the top. Here I can see the picture that I took, as well as the two sketches that I created. Now, let's pretend my meeting is over. I've got all this different information I captured inside of my Power App, and I'm ready to export it and save it to other places. To do that, I click the Finish and Save button here at the top. By default, Planner is selected because it saw we created a task. So we need to export that task to make sure it's saved somewhere. First thing I need to do is select a location. I'm presented with a list of all the different plans in Planner I have access to. Once I select a plan, then I can select the buckets within it. So the Power Apps and Flow Applications plan that I've selected right here with the to-do bucket correlates to the one that you see right here on this screen. I can also export to OneNote. Again, I'm able to select from different notebooks I have access to, as well as the sections within those notebooks. So I'm going to export to the Todd at Canvas LLC Quick Notes section. And here's what that one looks like right now. You can see I already have one export in it, but it's not the one that I'm about to create. Returning to the Power App, I have one more place to export. I can export to email. Here, I'm just going to select myself instead of all the other attendees so I don't spam the folks in my org with this test email. I can also add additional people to that as well by just putting in their name and merely selecting them. Like that. But I'll take Alex back out of there and clear this out just to make sure it goes to me. Next, I click the export button. It says, are you sure you're finished taking notes? Once you export, your meeting summary will be shared and you'll no longer have access to the edit page. Yep, I've got everything ready. I'll click yes, continue. At this point, the Power App is exporting to all those different locations. It takes just a minute and you'll see the information appear everywhere. Let's take a look at the email that it sent me first. Here's the email that I just received. You can see that we formatted the output to show you everything you saw within the Power App. The name of the meeting, the time and date it took place, as well as how long it was, how many people attended, and the meeting details. Scrolling down further, I can also see the meeting notes I took, as well as a link to Planner to go look at the tasks that I created. You'll also notice at the top, the photo I took, as well as the two images that I drew in the sketchpad are available here as well. The only place that you can export the photo and sketches is to email at this time. You can't put them into the Planner tasks or into OneNote. Now I can go over to Planner and I can see there is the task that I already created inside of the bucket, inside of the plan that I selected. Moving over to OneNote, here's the new one created in OneNote. Now I can select on it, and I can also see the details just like it looked like in the email here. Again, note that the pictures as well as the sketches at this time cannot be exported to OneNote, and that's why they do not show up here. We're not quite done yet. The Power App even has more functionality. Let me show it to you. go back to the Power app now and click Schedule a Follow-up Meeting. This allows you to quickly create a follow-up meeting with any of the attendees or other people you wish to add to talk about the topic at hand again. It's always so tough at the end of a meeting to do so, right? Everybody opens their calendar and says, oh, I'm open at Monday at 3, not me. How about Tuesday at 4? Well, the Power app makes it really easy to find a time that's going to work for anybody. You can like add more users like this by going to look for them down at the bottom, or you can just leave it with the people who are in it right now, put in a message for your follow-up, and then hit find available times. Here, you can select the different time range as well as the date that you'd like to have your follow-up meeting. So let's say I want to follow up on Wednesday for 1 hour between 8 a.m. and 5 p.m. Check out the cool slider up here too. If I change the time and shorten it up, the slider moves as well. Once you're done picking the date and time you'd like for your follow-up meeting, pick Find Available Times. At this point, the Power app will go out and check everybody's calendar and show you when people are available. Look at that. Everybody's available on Wednesday from 11 to 12. Once I select that and click Send Invite, the meeting invite is sent and everybody can accept it in Outlook just like they would if I actually made the meeting invite from Outlook itself. If some of the attendees are available at some times and not others, it won't just say 100 or 0% as well. Let's go look at a different date and time here. And here you can see just 25% of people have availability that day. So the Power app really tells you who can attend, and it makes it very easy to follow up and schedule those follow-up meetings as well. There's so many things going on this Power app. We had a great time building it. We really use it all the time. It's very handy. We hope it comes in very handy for you too and your organization, and we look forward to seeing how you extend it. Thanks for watching.